Thank you. everybody. My name is Carson Timmons, and I wrote the next piece on the concert. It is called Build Scene, and it follows, you can read the program notes, but it's about two woodpeckers that are separated by a forest and want to find each other in this forest. I wanted to extend some thank yous. Firstly, to my composition teacher, Professor Kyle Grimm. He really, as a bassist himself, helped me write this piece and really gave me the instruction that I needed. Also, to my advisor, Davis Martin, who helped me write this piece. And also I wanted to thank Christy Eccles, who actually, as part of my composition class, performed an earlier version of this piece and encouraged me to turn this into a full-fledged solo. So her encouragement really helped me get this piece going. And then finally, I wanted to thank my performer, Emily Byrne, who'll be out here in just a second, but I hope you enjoy the piece.
Speak on how my piece embodies the Joy and Troubles of Young Love. Enjoy.
Thank you. Among them worked with wonder and performed with valor, and lived with lordliness and majesty. Those powers have vanished, and the rebels are dead. I'd like to thank my performers, NicDaniel, Cassie, Pedro, and Sangha. I'd like to thank the committee that put this concert together, and I'd like to thank my composition teacher, Professor Lyons. This is the Seafarer.
actually knew what the title was going to be before I wrote the music. I thought this would be a fun capstone. This is the third time this piece has ever been performed. The first time I had it performed as part of my senior horn recital in my undergrad, then my composition recital, and since this is my last semester here at the Hart School, I thought this would be a fun little capstone for all of that. Each and every movement is just a simple little fun evocation, and the title kind of paints the picture that is. I'd like to thank those of you who are watching the live stream, those of you who decided to come out in person, and as well as my performers for obviously Julius, Pedro, Felix, Luke, and Taylor. Without them, this piece would just be hanging out there. So hope you enjoy.
Thank you. And even in the end, I wanted to have it not feel like it was coming to an end. So I hope you enjoy my piece. I want to thank my performers when they come up here. We have Diana, Helena, Marnio, Paul, and James Devon playing. And I want to thank you all for being here.
Thank you. referring to are the colors of the American flag. I've been working with an artist named Dr. Monument, and he's been producing artwork based off of the insurrection. He downloaded all these images and started creating this stunning artwork. And one of the pictures he downloaded was a picture of Ashford Babbitt, who died in his apple. And he has an American flag draped over this image. When I saw that image, I thought, you know, she was doing something that wasn't good, but her life was still valuable. But at the same time, the place where she lost her life was a place that thousands of African slaves lost their lives to. So the title is kind of a double entendre. It's lamenting the life of this woman who died, committing an act that most of us think was really hurtful to our country, in a space where people were brought to this country that looked like me and were forced to work and were killed to build the space that she was in. So it's like this reimagining of the capital space as sacred ground. Also, I'll say kind of coincidentally and definitely not intentionally, this entire ensemble that's going to be performing this piece is made up of current, former, or current and former, in the case of one, students of the Jack and Clean Institute of Jazz here at the Hart School. Get out of here, you don't realize how supportive it really is. So let's just give them a round of applause.